Aftershocks are rattling Taiwan as rescuers work to free more than 100 people still trapped after yesterday's powerful earthquake. The 7.4 magnitude tremor has left 9 people dead and 1,000 injured, while dozens of buildings are damaged.
Easy driving music intercut by the blare of a mobile warning system. The road rocks. Then the real threat arrives, boulders plummeting down the mountainsides of Taiwan's east coast. One car struck and a terrifying near miss as the island is hit by its worst earthquake in a quarter of a century. In Hualien City, the quake arrived with an almighty rumble. Those who can run for safety, and moments later, this building crumbles at its foundations, left teetering on the edge at a 45-degree angle.
还好吗?
Inside, just as dangerous as out, maternity nurses scramble to keep cots still and newborns safe, fearing the ward's windows may shatter. Scenes like this playing out in home after home. Western Australian MP Tanya Lawrence felt the full force. She was holidaying right by the epicentre, telling Nine News she feared for her life.
The room was shaking so incredibly violently, we could not stand. Quite honestly, we just thought that's going to be the last thing we're going to see, and just felt resigned to our fate, expecting the floors to concertina down upon us, and I just thought it was going to hurt.
Tonight, the search for survivors. It's a delicate, piece-by-piece operation. Dozens of people are trapped, the majority inside two mines and a collapsed highway tunnel. The earthquake struck just before 8 o'clock Wednesday morning, and at least 29 aftershocks followed. The epicentre of the 7.4 magnitude quake was on the east of the island, just offshore from Hualien County. The force felt right across the country.
The sway of the buildings, the building was so much that you thought, oh my God, it's going to collapse around me.
Tonight, the island nation shaken and scrambling to recover. Lauren Tomasi, Nine News.